Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton and it is time to finally figure out what is the difference between WordPress.com and WordPress.org. If you're brand new to the WordPress world, that might be totally confusing to you. Are there two different versions? Is one more expensive than the other? What's actually the difference? Let's talk about it. All right, for the sake of this tutorial, I'm gonna go ahead and start with the .org version, because that's really the one that gives you more flexibility, all right? But even though WordPress is free to use, the .org version does require you to basically come here and download WordPress and put it on a server space somewhere. So that would be a hosting company like WP Engine, like GoDaddy, like HostGator, one of those companies out there that can host a WordPress website. Some of those companies even offer a one-click install where you can skip coming over here to this website and clicking download, but you actually go purchase it, or purchase your hosting rather, on their website and click a button and it installs it all for you. That's super slick. We love that. But it also gives you a lot of flexibility when you're using the .org version. You're able to add free themes as well as premium themes. You're able to add in all sorts of plugins. It kind of just opens up the box to let you do whatever you want to your website, allowing you to do customization, allowing you to do a shopping cart, allowing you to do incredible photo galleries and video galleries and awesome social media. And you really just have a whole lot of customization options if you're able to spend some money and go ahead and do the .org version. Now, the .com version, free is always in the budget, right? You hear me say that all the time on our YouTube channel here. Free is always in the budget. So this is your free option if you really want to use WordPress.com. Just come over here, click Create a Website, and basically what they're going to allow you to do is in just a couple of clicks, you're going to fill out some information totally for free. You can start your WordPress website right here. They basically give you the server space for free, but you will have something like, let's say I did one, my name of my blog would be, if I chose to name it Webtegrity after my company, it would be webtegrity.wordpress.com. So that's how you get a free, totally free version of WordPress. But if you wanted to maybe have it point to a different address and not have wordpress.com in there, you can do an upgrade for that. If you wanted to use some higher-end premium themes, you can kind of do an upgrade for that. And there's all these little charges that start to kind of play into effect that ultimately no longer have you in a budget of free. But if you really wanted to be totally, totally free, you can just go over here and tinker around and play and say, hey, I want to build a website and I'm going to talk about travel. And so here would be some of your theme options that you're able to use, again, totally for free. But you will be limited to just, you know, choosing from a very limited amount, kind of a pre-selected amount of themes if you're using the .com version. So that's why we definitely suggest going over to the .org version and having fun. I hope that this helps you. If you're logged in your dashboard and you're not seeing a lot of theme options, if you have no ability to upload a theme that you might have purchased from a third party, more than likely, you are over on the .com version. So if you've already built there and you want to go ahead and transfer over to the .org version, there is an option for you to pay. I think it's about $130 or so to have WordPress.com engineers move your whole website over to the self-hosted version, and that'll kind of open it up and allow you to do some of that fun customization and creativity. I also want to send you to another video here on YouTube. And this is by just an awesome guy over on WP 101, and I talk about them all the time, WP101.com. Check them out. And this is one of his really great videos that talks a little bit more about the difference between .com and .org. I'll put that link in the description box below. I hope you're having a great day. I will see you next WordPress Wednesday. Bye-bye, y'all.